Hello, welcome to the video number 6 of this series exploring ROS with a two-wheeled robot. My name is Marco Arruda, and in this video we are going to work on an algorithm to make our robot to go from a point to another. So in order to start, I'm going to use RDS, ROS Development Studio. If you don't have an account yet, you can create one clicking on this link, sign up, and you're going to be able to see this screen where you can take a look on the public projects and your own private projects. In this case, I'm gonna just open the previous project I have been working in the last video. So let's open it, open project, and wait a few seconds until our environment is ready. Okay, it's done. So let's check our IDE where I have the source code. So we have here, the last script we have worked on was the obstacle avoidance. So for this video, we're gonna create a new one called go to point. Okay, so this is a Python script. Let's start making sure that our script is executable. So I'm gonna open a new terminal here. Get into the catkin workspace, motion plan. Inside scripts we have some files, and okay, it's executable. So go to point py. And let's start doing like this. So this is a Python script. We have also to import some ROS stuff. So we need ROS Py, of course, because we're working with ROS and Python. We are going to work with laser. So import from sensor messages, laser scan, geometry messages, twist and point. We're going to use both objects, both classes. And from nav messages, the odometry, because this time we need to know the position of the robot, and we have to control this position to go from a point to another. So we're going to use the odometry measurement of the robot to do that. Okay. We're going to also need the transformation library, because we're going to check the heading of the robot in order to go from a point to another. So from odometry message we have just a quaternion, and we want to convert it to row, pitch and yaw. It makes our life easier. Okay, and finally the math library, because we're going to work with a constant pi to check some stuff of the robot, and also another functions to make conversions and calculate distance, etc. Okay, so let's define here. It's very important to define from the beginning that we're gonna create like a state machine for the robot, because going to a point is gonna treat like that. So we have first the fixed heading state, which means that we want to go to a point in a straight line, but in order to do that we have to make sure that we are heading to the correct place. Okay, so we are gonna start fixing the heading of the robot, and if the heading is good enough, if it's not, it stays fixing the heading, and if it is good enough, we are gonna go straight ahead to the point, and if it's close enough, the task is done. Otherwise, just go straight ahead. And also, it's very important to check if the heading is good enough, even after having it fixed here in the previous state, because going in a straight line, of course our robot's not perfect, the simulation is not perfect. Also in the real world, the robot's not perfect, so it may happen that the robot loses the heading, or just maybe hitting an obstacle, and it can lose the heading, okay? That's why we are always checking if the heading is good enough for the robot to go in a straight line, okay? So these are basically the three states we're gonna have in our robot for our state machine, and let's start implementing in our code. So basically I want to have some global variables here. Let's start with the robot state. So robot state variables, I'm gonna use this underscore at the end of the variable just to remember that this is a global variable, okay, so we won't make confusion inside the methods and etc. So we have also a state machine, so let's define here state, and it starts from zero, which is the fixed heading state. And then let's define a goal. Actually, we can do it using arguments, like defining in a ROS launch file, etc. But for instance, let's have it inside our script, and then we can put it outside of the file. Okay. So we have a desired position. In this case, I have defined it here 5 for x, y equals to h, and z of course 0 because we are working with a ground robot, so z is always 0. Okay, and some parameters here. I want yaw precision, we have to define it, and also distance precision. It means that if the heading is more or less 2 degrees, it's okay, it's fine, it's good enough for my application. And if the distance of the robot to the desired position is less than 0.3 meters, it's okay for me. So that's good enough for my application. Okay. Of course, you can change these parameters as you want. So I'm gonna define here a publisher variable, which is the publisher to the command velocity. Let's start now our main function. So some Python definitions here. And let's define our main function. So we have here, we are using the global variable publisher. Okay. We are initializing our node. Let's call it goToPoint. We are gonna publish to the command velocity. We are subscribing to the laser. In this case, actually, we're not gonna use that, so I'm gonna remove it. That's because I started from the other script. But the most important here is that we are gonna read our position from the odometry topic, so we have to subscribe to it. So I have created this variable here, subodom, which is subscribing to the slash odom topic. Odometry is the kind of this of the messages, and the callback is clbk odom. Okay, we have to define it yet, that's why we have this x here. So we have our state machine, and if it's only state number 0, we are going to fix the yaw or fix heading. State number 1 is go straight ahead, and finally done, which is state number 2. Okay, done. Otherwise, this is an unknown state. And finally, rate sleep, which means that we're gonna work in a 20 hertz frequency. Okay, so let's start creating our methods. So we have the callback method for the odometry. And I have here, let me check. Basically, what we have to do inside this method is to get the position from the odometry and save in our global variables, which are the position and the yaw we want to know. So I'm taking the position from the message, which is message pose pose position. Why pose pose position? Because the first one is pose with covariance, and inside this object we have pose and covariance. In this case, we just want to work with the pose, and inside pose we have position and orientation. This for the position, just the position variable, okay, which has x, y, and z values. For the yaw, we are receiving a quaternion, which comes from message pose pose orientation, and we have x, y, z, and w. I am defining here a quaternion, and using the transformation method that we have imported here at the beginning of the script to convert to Euler angles. Okay, so either from quaternion, passing this quaternion variable as argument, and we have the yaw right here. Okay, if you want to work with row and pitch, you just have to do like this. But in this case, just to have this knowledge, but it's not necessary for this application. Okay, so now we have to define our state method, which are fix yaw, go straight ahead, and done. Let's start with the fix yaw method. I'm gonna define it right here. So we have fix yaw. And inside this function, we have basically some, we are using some global variables. That's why I'm defining right here, global. So we're gonna work with the yaw variable because we want to fix it, the heading of the robot. The publisher, because we're gonna work, we are gonna publish a twist message to the command velocity topic. The yaw precision, we're gonna use it. And also the state of the robot, always using it along the script. So first of all, we are defining the desired yaw, which comes from this math function here, tangent function, using the desired position, the difference of the desired position and the current position of the robot for Y and X. You can check at the Python documentation later what this function does, okay? And the error of the yaw, desired yaw minus the current yaw of the robot. Okay, and we are using it to define in which direction we are gonna rotate the robot. Okay, so twist message is being defined right here, and if the error of the yaw is greater than the yaw precision, we are gonna define an angular velocity around the z-axis. Okay, and here we are just defining the direction of the rotation, because if it's a positive value, use the positive velocity, otherwise a negative velocity. Okay, and finally publishing the message. At the end of the state, we are checking, remember here, every time we are executing this state, we have to check if we have to change the state or not, or stay here working to fix it. In this case, I'm checking the error of the yaw, just the absolute value, float absolute value of error yaw is less or equal yaw precision. If it is, it means that the heading is good enough for me, and then I change the state, and I change to the state number 1, which is going a straight line. So let's define this function here, change state, which is right here. I am using a separate function to change the state, because actually it's very simple, it's just assigning the value of the state variable, but I want also to have this message here, and I don't want to write it every time I change the state, okay? So for the second state, which is the go straight ahead, let's take a look at our function here. Let's define it just below the fix heading. So we have here go straight ahead, and we have the desired position as an argument. We're using also the yaw, the publisher, yaw precision, and state. And so we start here like the previous function, defining the desired yaw and the error of the yaw, and then error position. We are using here some math functions to define the error. Okay, so the distance we have from the robot position to the desired position, and then if the error position is greater than the distance, the precision we want, in this case is 0.3 meters, which means that we want to go to the point. So we are defining here a velocity in the linear x axis, equals to 0.6, and we are publishing the message. Okay. Otherwise, we have a very small error, and the position is good enough for us. And then we change to the state done, state number 2. Okay. And again, at the end of the function, if we have a problem with the yaw, we get back to the state number 0. Okay. So we are checking the yaw again. If it's not good enough, get back to the fixed heading. If it's good enough, keep going in a straight line. Okay. And finally, the done method. Let's define it here, which is basically, we may have asked to yourself, what do I have to do, because the robot's already in the position. Actually, we just have to stop the robot. Okay. Otherwise, the robot's going to keep
obeying to the last twist message, right? So just defining a twist message here with zero values and publish this message just once, okay? So I think everything is ready. Let's try to see it working. In order to do that, let's open our simulation. So from our simulation workspace, so from my words package, we're launch. Let's launch it. Wait a few seconds until we have the word running. Let's make it quite bigger and put the ID to the left side. And in our shell, we have to spawn the robot after having the word ready. So I have here ROS launch. Let's take a look. A better look at the scene. Okay, so here we have. Let's spawn the robot more or less here. This is the positive y-axis, so more or less HE. Okay. So ROS launch, my two-wheeled robot spawn y equals to H. Okay, here we have, and let's run our script. So from motion plan package, go to point, and the robot must go to the point x equals to 5 and y equals to h. So we have y-axis positive here, x positive here, and z upwards. Okay, let's run it. I'm sorry, x-axis positive in this direction here, and we have the robot. You can see here the robot went in a straight line because the heading was already okay, and in the middle of the path the robot had a problem with the heading, so it changed to the state number 0 to fix the heading and then go back to the state number 1 to go in a straight line. So let's define another point here. Of course, you have noticed that I am avoiding the obstacles because we are going to work with the obstacles and the go to point function in the next video. Okay, so let's try again changing the point. So let's put here 7 in Y, which is more or less this point here, and for X let's put -3. Let's stop it and run again, and the robot must get to this point, more or less this point here. Okay, so you can notice that the robot is always changing between 0 and 1 because the heading is always being affected while the robot goes in a straight line. Okay, okay, finally the robot reached the point and it changed to the state number 2. That's it. I hope you enjoyed this video. Don't forget, if you like this kind of video, if you are enjoying this series of videos, don't forget to subscribe to our channel, press the bell to be notified about the videos we publish every day. I see you in the next video. See you. Bye.